Our GMA exclusive interview with award-winning Christian music star Stephen Curtis Chapman and his beautiful family. They are speaking out for the first time about the death of their beloved five-year-old daughter, Maria. She died this past May after her teenage brother accidentally ran over her in the family driveway. And as you can imagine, their grief is still enormous so soon after a tragedy like this. But when I sat down with them recently in their home in Nashville, Tennessee, I saw a family closer than ever before, there for one another, and a family facing the future with great hope.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Maria Sue Chapman. Oh, that's the crowd. Okay, they're ready. Go. You're on.
For Maria Sue Chapman, singing was a family gift that came naturally. Her father, multi-award-winning Christian music megastar, Stephen Curtis Chapman. This is life we've been given, made to be lived out. Stephen and his wife, Mary Beth, were already the parents of three children, yet they were inspired by the encouragement of their daughter, Emily, to go three times to China to adopt their little girls, Shohanna, Stevie Joy, and their youngest, Maria. They invited me to their home outside of Nashville, and Stephen remembered the moment he knew they were destined to return to China and adopt Maria, the orphan girl he met while on tour there. It was an email of this photo from his trip that changed all their lives.
And as it opened, it was instant. I knew that that was a picture of a daddy kissing his little girl. It wasn't just a guy with a little child that needed a home. It was a daddy and a little girl. It was just so clear when I saw it.
The Chapman family was complete, and Maria grew into her role as the baby girl of this loving family. We're washing dishes and we're having some fun.
We're going to drive when the washing is done. Tell us about your daughter.
We knew from the get-go that she was a firecracker. And, you know, even in China, just personality, contagious, just complete, just joyful, happy little baby.
Tragically, on May 21st, Maria died in a family driveway accident. Her 17-year-old brother, Will Franklin, was at the wheel. He was returning home.
The girls had been playing on the playground in complete accident. She was actually excited that he was coming home, and he is so great with the girls, and she was running to see him and you know, ran, you know, into the path of the car. So.
And Stephen, I know that you had the presence of mind when you were getting into the car to go to the hospital, and understand Will was just inconsolable. Mm. And you rolled down the window and you told him something.
As we drove out the driveway, and I really don't remember this, it was actually Dave, Uncle Dave, that told me. He said, you rolled the window down and just very loudly yelled it, really, you know, as with as much strength as you could muster, and just said, Will Franklin, your father loves you. It felt like at that moment, you know, we weren't sure. I don't know. I think somewhere in our hearts maybe had a sense that we were maybe losing or had already lost our daughter. But I just really had a deep concern in my heart that I wouldn't lose two children as a result of this, because I knew what Will was struggling with.
How do you grieve and also be there for your children?
We've talked a lot, and you will hear all of us talk about the process of grieving with hope. That's such a, for us, that's what has kept us breathing, kept us alive, is that while we are grieving this process, there is a hope that we have, that we're anchored to in the midst of just what sometimes seems unbearable.
I've said, you know, somewhat coldly, I don't care whose lives are touched by this story and whose lives are changed or what good comes of it. At the heart of a mom, I want Maria back. Mm. And that's, you know, that's what I want people to know, is I want Maria back. But because I know that she is completely whole, because of my faith, I know that she's completely whole and completely okay, and I'm going to see her again. As a mom, I have to shift that grief to go. I have Emily, who's getting married, and her fiancé Tanner, and Caleb, and his girlfriend Julia, and Will Franklin. You know, he's my baby boy, and then Joey and Stevie, and my grief gets shifted to making sure they're as whole and as healthy as they can be. And through that, then, when people's lives are changed and touched, then I can be okay with that. But as the heart of a mom, I'd like to have Maria back.
For the three oldest Chapman children, Emily, Caleb, and Will, healing comes through counseling and faith. And for Will, it's the unwavering love from his family that supports him most.
How has your family helped you, Will?
Obviously, it's been really hard, you know, just the past couple months. Because I started running after the accident, you know, and started just running away from the house. And I remember Caleb, you know, was the first one to run and kind of just jump on me and hold me. And then Shoei was right there by him. And that, to me, you know, that meant a ton, because I didn't really want to be at the house. I just wanted to be away, you know, and I was just mm-hmm. freaking out. I've gotten a stronger faith through all this, but then there's those days, you know, that just hit you and you're just like, oh man, this is just awful. You just got to continue to choose to live, and that's the faith that, you know, that continues to keep me going.
How have you helped each other as children?
When you see someone hurting and you see someone burdened, you want to take that burden from them, and because you rather endure that pain than see your brother, in this case, my for real brother, endure that pain.
Grief is this windy road, I feel like, and sometimes you turn the corner and you've got a straightaway and it's beautiful, and then you can turn a corner at the end of that straightaway and it's thunderstorms and mountains, and it can be hard, and even within the same day.
My son said the other day that, you know, we are a family. A lot of people say, you know, of great faith, but we're a family with a lot of questions. But that's what faith is. It's living with the questions.
For the Chapmans, the burden is lifted by the grace of grief shared.
So I dance with Cinderella while she's here.
Chapman's current hit song, Cinderella, was written one night while getting his little princesses ready for bed. Incredibly, he wrote the words to remind him to appreciate each moment with his girls before they grew up. After losing Maria, Stephen thought he could never sing the song again. But now the words have an even stronger meaning.
I have to sing it because I have to continue, you know, these chapters that are still being written with my two little girls, Shohanna and Stevie Joy, and Emily, who's getting ready to be married. We need to keep living these moments, these living years that we have, these moments that we have. I still need to be engaged in those, and I need to be dancing with my Cinderellas. I'm gonna dance with Maria again. I'm absolutely sure of that.
It's all too soon, the clock will strike midnight. And she'll be gone.
Despite their immense pain, so open, so honest about their feelings and grieving with hope, and that they do have questions. They don't question their faith, but they do have many questions as a family.
That's right, and that you don't get to, no one has the right to have a life without struggle in it, and the way they've accepted what was dealt them. What a family. They also have thousands of people who are donating to an adoption charity.
Maria's Miracle Fund, they didn't ask for people to do this, but they just on their own and wanted to help with adoptions and things like that, and they do have a family charity, and you can find out more about that at our website at abcnews.com.
In a flash, be the first to know what's coming up on Good Morning America tomorrow with the GMA Daily Flash email. All the great insider details you want to know from GMA. Go to abcnews.com, click the GMA page, and sign up for the Daily Flash. And you can even enter to win the weekly GMA Flash gift bag giveaway. Sign up now.